After their successes with Fallout 1 and 2, Black Isle Studios was working on a third installment. Unfortunately, before they could complete the game, Interplay Entertainment, who owned the studio, went bankrupt and Black Isle Studios was closed down. Seeing potential in the Fallout franchise, Bethesda Softworks bought the license to develop a new Fallout game. Development began in 2004, but only real progress would be made in 2006 after the release of Bethesda's title The Elder Scrolls IV Oblivion. Developers working on Oblivion also worked on Fallout 3 and used the same engine. After 4 years of development, the game was finally released in October 2008. Upon its release, Fallout 3 received numerous awards and is nowadays considered as one of the best video games ever made. And with a reputation like that, I have to see for myself if this game is worthy of its current legacy. As a newcomer to the Fallout franchise, I can determine whether this is a good starting point if you've never played the Fallout game.
The apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes.
If you've played the first two games, the first change you will immediately notice is that you play Fallout 3 from the first person perspective instead of the top down perspective. In the tutorial, you are born as a citizen of Vault 101, and in this section the game teaches you all the basics, including movement, the HUD, combat, how to interact with characters and items, and the Pip-Boy 3000. In this section you can adjust your appearance to your liking and give your character a name. And with the so-called special system, which stands for strength, perception, endurance, charisma, intelligence, agility, and luck, you can assign points to your character's attributes. The game takes place in 2277, 200 years after the Great War started and ended. Once your father James leaves the vault unannounced, the game really starts to get going. To avoid getting arrested, you also need to leave the vault, find your father, and find out why he decided to leave. After leaving the vault, you can go wherever you want to go to. This freedom is refreshing, as lots of games force you to go down a linear path. Still, if this freedom seems daunting, fear not, as the game informs you at all times where the location is of the next main quest, leaving you as the player free to decide if you only do main story quests or also bother to do side quests. My favorite quest is without a doubt Tranquility Lane, where you get tasked by a little girl named Betty that ends with you brutally killing all of the citizens of Tranquility Lane. Or you can ignore Betty's tasks and activate a failsafe. And this is just a perfect example of how you as the player are free to complete the game's quest to your liking. By completing quests and killing enemies, you earn experience points, and by leveling up you get points that you can use to improve your skills. This includes improving your lockpicking, speech, sneak, and many more skills. Aside from that, you can also pick another perk, such as increasing your weapon accuracy with a Commando perk, or choosing the Lead Belly perk to take less radiation from drinking radioactive water. Around the world there are also skill books that you can read to permanently increase your skills. Along your journey you will come across two factions, the Enclave, who want to destroy all other lifeforms, and the Brotherhood of Steel, that go against this ideal. Thus the Brotherhood are seen as the good guys, while the Enclave are the bad guys. Of course, things aren't as black and white, and after freeing your father you can decide whose plans you will carry out. This means that in the end you can either go for the good ending and save the Purifier, or use the modified VIV virus that the Enclave President Eden gave you, which is dangerous and will therefore kill most humans, but the Enclave will survive, resulting in the bad ending. I decided to sacrifice myself by going into the radioactive chamber where the Purifier is located and activate Project Purity. The Broken Steel DLC adds more endings and fixes an issue where you could not let your partner Fox go into the chamber, which is frustrating as he is a super mutant and is thus immune to the radiation inside the chamber, which made the sacrifice of your character less heroic and more like an idiot and reckless decision. Still, it's inexcusable that you have to get the DLC to be able to unlock this feature, and it should have just been included with the free patch.
So ends the story of the Lone Wanderer, who stepped through the great door of Vault 101 and into the annals of legend. But the tale of humanity will never come to a close, for the struggle of survival is a war without end. And war never changes.
While you can shoot enemies like your regular first-person shooter, it's much more effective to use the newly introduced VATS, short for Vault Tech Assisted Targeting System. This system stops time, allowing you to carefully target a specific body part of your enemy, making your shots much more precise. You can stack up attacks, but this costs action points, so you can't unload an entire magazine into your enemy. At first I thought this system would get old really quickly, but this is not the case, and seeing gory deaths in slow motion remains entertaining to watch even at the end of the game. Don't just use your weapons mindlessly though, as they can quickly degenerate, reducing their damage and accuracy. This can be especially true for the hunter rifles, which can be frustratingly inaccurate at times. Aside from equipping weapons, you can also equip armor and clothing that make you more resistant against incoming attacks, as well as giving additional bonuses such as increasing your skills. At a certain point, you will exceed your inventory's weight limit, which reduces your movement speed and prevents you from fast traveling. Thus, it is important to occasionally head back and sell your useless stuff before you venture forward. You don't have to travel the world alone and can have a party of up to 3 companions, though I only teamed up with Fox towards the end of the game, as only then did I realize this was possible, and because Fox is one of my favorite, if not my favorite character of the game. Along your journey, you should also be mindful of your actions, as thanks to the karma system, your good and bad deeds are remembered by NPCs. So if you want NPCs to like you, you shouldn't steal all of their stuff.
Thank you, you're a saint.
While the game can be a bit dull in the color department, with the wasteland being brown and grayish, it still looks fairly detailed, though the world can feel a bit empty at times. Character models in Fallout 3 still hold up all these years after its initial release. The voice acting is good, though the faces can be a bit static. Aside from that, the game is accompanied by a fantastic soundtrack. The bigger issue for me is regarding the performance. I don't know if it is just my copy of the game, but the game froze a lot while playing, which meant I saved a lot more just to make sure that I didn't lose long minutes of playing. Luckily, saving frequently made the moments when the game froze less annoying. After completing the story of Fallout 3, I felt accomplished. It really feels like the choices you make matter, which can't be said for a majority of RPGs. Often problems you come across have a variety of solutions, which makes this game highly replayable. Even if this isn't the case, the illusion of choice is still appreciated. I ended up focusing on using small weapons and putting a lot of points in my repair and medic skills, and this freedom in playstyle is great. Despite a few annoying performance issues, the game never ceased to be fun, and I get why this game is so highly praised, and I'm eager to check out other games in the Fallout series. So if, like me, you've never played a Fallout game before, I highly advise you to do so, and Fallout 3 is a great starting point.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start.